So, we're going to go with the poppy next. I have, this is what it looks like. I'm afraid I couldn't actually resist starting, and I have just done the stem. I couldn't stop myself. I've pulled out some fabrics. I've got lots of reds going into sort of oranges, well, sort of dusky orangey pinks, I suppose. Hopefully that's enough. If not, I'll have to grab some more. What I'm going to start with is the flower, top flower, and I'm going to start with the palest colours first and work my way around. That's the plan. So let's grab some parchment paper and do my tracing on. So this is the palest colour that I've got. So this is the one I'm going to start with. So I'm going to start up here. Let's just move the camera up a bit. Stretching on my tiptoes. So that's the first bit. Now I have to look for my scissors. What have I done with scissors? And this is the problem when you clear up. Ah, there they are. Start a new project. After I finished an old project, I tend to have a good old clear up. Maybe I do that. My arms are just gonna put it down. I'm gonna pull this right there. Can't reach it. I'm gonna have to go up and down. There's been a lot of interest in the scissors this week. They're Fiskars Easy Action, and I love them because they don't involve your fingers getting, because I'm a dog groomer, I've got to obviously use a lot of scissors, and any ones with like the holes in, they tend to wreak havoc on the top of my fingers, so that bit there. You'll probably see I actually hold my scissors, because I'm a dog groomer, you're taught to hold your scissors probably slightly differently to the way everybody else does. So this finger is the only one that hasn't got, but these don't have anything that comes over the top, so they're just nice and easy to use. I love them. Somebody recommended them to me, so I'm recommending them to you. And they're great if you haven't, you know, you haven't got the strongest fingers, because and they're just really easy to control. Right. Here's my first bit. Just like the yarn bag up. And that's just going to sit in there. there's obviously lots of flower designs, so I like to try and do things slightly different, so I've just gone for a slightly different angle, sort of looking up through them rather than the usual sort of angle that you look at flowers. See if I can make you all seasick today. Right, and I want this a little bit here as well, in the same colour. And just that little bit there as well. In here. Use up all these tiny little bits that I've trimmed off already. It's also part of this area over here as well. So I'm going to carry on with the same fabric because I want it all to tie in. I've done bigger size again. So I do quite like the bigger size. I think they're a bit more versatile to what you can do with them. definitely have a bit more impact as well, being bigger. I could, looking at my pattern, what I could have done is I could have cut out this whole area in this fabric and then just cut these ones out, which would have made more sense. But I didn't think about that. But you guys could do. It would just save you a little bit more time. Yeah, I'm just going to draw them. I'm going to do what I suggested I was going to do, but just with this end bit. Let's work out where. So this is a darker piece here. I'm going to draw it on now. Across there. And right up to here I want. And that's a different colour. So this time I'm going to cut out this whole piece. Stick the extra bits on top. That goes like that, and I'm gonna just tuck it down. I can easily peel it back up again to see where I've got to go, and so that I don't lose those bits, I'm gonna cut them out So I just need to work out at what colour they need to be. So let's just put the fabrics out. And I'm going to use that as well. So this is the palest colour that I've just used. This is kind of the next one down, which I think, no it's not, this is the one, the next one down. So that's going to go into that. So it's going to have to be one of these really quite dark colours. So I could use that, or I could use that, but I quite think that would work really well with this bit around here. So I think I'm going to go with that. I've also got this colour as well, but I think this would work well around the base. So just gonna pop this on here because it is all drawn out, so I should just be able to just cut it out. Right, so that's cut out. It's a bit delicate, so I need to, I'm just gonna make sure it's well adhered to my fabric. Then I need to be a bit delicate as I unroll it. She says, not able to get it off. There we go. Right, and then I'll just pull this back so I can work out where that's going. It's a wee bit long, but I can trim that, but I'm just going to stick it in place. see what's going on. So that actually gets cut off. It's the same colour that runs through here, so because I'm on that colour, I'm just going to do it. This is going to fit behind the other pieces of the fabric. So, let's go back here and have a look. I need a very pale piece running across the top of there. And then maybe these ones over here for that particular flower. I'm actually thinking I might even go even paler for that one. So I'm going to stop and see if I can find that particular colour that I want. Okay, so there we go. I found that, which I think will work fine. So I just need to make sure that is the bit I need. Yes. So just draw around that bit. Goes on there. And we set these few bits down here. So I'm going to draw around this whole block. Bit out. There we go. That's out of this. a fairly reddish red. Which makes perfect sense, doesn't it? It's quite a reddish red. It's even more of a reddish red. Maybe not quite as red as that. No, I'm going to go with that one. I think fabric choice is probably the hardest part, especially when you're doing something like this where you've got lots of different tones of red. Alright, so this bit is going to go under here somewhere. Right. So it goes that way around. And sort of sits like that. Up a bit there. That's it. Right, so that is basically it for that particular colour on that flower. So I'm going to stop now and I'm going to do the same on the other flower and maybe put another colour in as well. And then we'll come back and do something else. Bye.